tell you what the situation is here. See, one day we got legs and abdomen. You got that?
Yeah.
The next day is tremendous supersets of the arms, the back, and curls. Now, make sure you write it down that the Black Brotherhood be doing it religiously.
And everything's for real. That's our motto. You got that?
Yeah, got it. Okay.
And we training towards perfect harmony between the body and mind as ordained by the Prophet Al-Rashid.
Yeah, man. Also put in there that the Black Brotherhood is the baddest thing in the Iron Power. We number one. Dick, wait, let me write that down for you.
Okay.
Number one, right on. Put that in your sports page. Number one.
Man, I am very thirsty. When's the next batch of Pruno?
That's another thing. Smiling Jack down at the still. He doesn't run out of sugar.
Trip on over to Rubio's, Baby Blue. See if the man will sell us some.
All right.
Hey, homeboy.
Yeah.
You ready to sports page?
That's it.
Orderly, orderly. Write this down, man.
Okay.
Los Indios del Barrio. We're doing it.
Yes, señor.
Yeah, the mean ones, the wild Chicanos.
Eso.
Orderly. By the soldiers of 10-4 Street, man. We're moving on up in the handball rating to numero uno. Numero uno.
Numero uno.
Because of their skills, their aggression,
you got
and
that
their
pato?
Heart. You got it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You got the eso.
Right.
Yes,
last batch of prunos you bought those men was so lousy you should pay the people to drink it.
Oh, man, what can I tell you? It got you off, didn't it?
You want a peach?
No, man, I want some sugar. We're making up a new batch.
I can't help you, bro. My canal at the grocery store got busted for isolation. But there's a new dude coming in to clerk the store. If I make a connection, I'll help you out. But then, my supermarket is out of stock. That's it, bro. Punto final. Later.
Vale, Rubio. Huevo nuevo. Chaca, hey.
Inside the wallet we have for y'all, show you how much money it is. There happens to be a $100 bill.
It's real.
Another $100 bill.
All right, right on.
If you like that, here's the big event, $1,000. I'm just standing right back here, just in case.
Here comes
on the line.
Here
on the line.
I, that's right.
Hey, where's my map?
There, where it's nice and safe for me.
Come on, Joe. Your pedigree. I'm your daddy.
Put a lid on that garbage. Get on me, Jackson. You jab. Hippie, tippy. Crack a bounce ball. What's your cell now?
Get a riffraff out of the find
out
where you live at,
John.
Come on out.
Hey, hey, hey! Boogaloo! Hey, what I got in the mail? Here, a picture of my new kid. A new one. Boy, she gonna be a dynamite African woman. Hey, hey, crazy man. Hey, look here, you want to see a picture of my little girl? Hey, man, I got to write me a letter.
Good.
I'm going to tell Waylene every itty-bitty little detail of what we going to do to each other when I get up in them trailers on my conjugal visit. Yeah. Hey, man, look here. Now, here's a treat for your eyes.
Yeah, I'm warming down, man.
Hey, come on, man. It's only a picture. It ain't gonna burn your hand. Yeah. Huh? Now, is she beautiful or is she beautiful? My conjugal don't come up for 3 months. Now, how am I gonna do that?
Can't do time, don't mess with crime. That's the price you pay for rehabilitation.
My love life ain't never needed no rehabilitating. 3 months, man. 3 long months. Hey, I filed the whole child on my conjugal visit in this joint. I ain't even seen it yet.
Attention, attention. 330 lockdown is coming up.
3 months? Hey, did you see that picture, man? Huh? Did you just look at her?
Yeah.
Clear the bars, clear the bars.
Hey, man, what's happening?
Bay City Wrecking Crew softball team is doing great. The Big Three is still number one on the handball court, taking on all comers. What is this with the sports page? You got all winners, no losers.
So what do you want me to say? Somebody's a loser? You turn the switch taking this joint.
Your pictures are getting better, though. What's with this guy here, Murphy?
Murphy? Goof, nutter, runs around in circles.
He just got remanded to me for counseling.
You're jiving. Good luck.
Why?
Guy doesn't talk to anybody.
Is he fast?
I don't know. Runs a couple fast miles in the morning, tries to get an extra mile in before the 3:30 lockdown.
Does he run the mile in?
How should I know?
Put a clock on
him. I'm prepping page 2 for the compositor. Jerry's taking forever laying out page 1. When have I got time to clock some goof who runs around in circles?
How about tomorrow? Got out there in that yard, Warden?
Murphy.
Murphy, the guy who runs around all day?
What about him?
You ever curious about how fast he's going?
Now that you mention it, no.
Well, that man is out there on a regular basis, day in, day out, week in, week out, apparently running close to 4-minute miles.
Are you putting me on?
No, I'm not. They've got a mile measured out there. I think it's 14 and a half times around the ball field, something.
Do you know how many runners anywhere run a 4-minute mile?
What could he do on a good track?
Where does he work?
He doesn't. He runs, period. You know what I think? I don't think he knows how fast he's going.
What are you going to do to carry this further?
I have to talk to him.
Karen, I want the track coach at Sacramento State, Jerry Beloit, on the phone.
Yes, Warden.
Hey, bro. Look here, man, I gotta talk to you.
Yeah, well, what's to it, pal of mine?
I need someone to do something for someone in records.
Someone being you?
Yeah, okay. I want a conjugal visit, man.
Woo, man. That's heavy duty stuff, you know that.
Hey, man, I missed the last one because my old lady had a problem in the hospital after delivering the baby, you know. Now, I ain't due for 3 more months.
Oh, man, I know, I feel for you. That's tough. But I bet you got a design around that, ain't you?
Hey, I want my jacket tricked out. A couple of dates changed, you know. You got your man in records, and hey, my old lady boogies on in here. Now, I know your man has got the juice.
Conjugal visit, huh? Look, I want to do it for you. I really do. But Dr. D, he's going to want to know what you're talking about doing for us, so I don't know.
Sugar for your still, man. The word is that the sugar supply for your Pruno still dried up when Rubio's dude got busted to isolation. Now, I'm the one taking his place.
Yeah, now, that's enough said, pal. I'll be talking to you a little later, and I'll go talk to the man right now.
All right.
Check you later, huh?
Yeah. Yeah. Coming through.
What's that dude down for?
Come up from San Quentin about 3 or 4 months ago.
Hey, where's his house?
Well, he stayed next door to Lickety Split. Oh, Abadaba said he works at No. 2 mess hall back in the grocery room.
You know, a man in a position like that can do a great deal to enhance the political economy of Africans in this joint. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, man, why don't you talk to the brother? You know what I mean? Because Rubio's price steaks and cheese is way too high, man. So we just ought to go and get our man in there, right?
Right on, right on, right on.
Got it knocked, baby.
Yeah? What are you talking about?
My wife and my kid, man. I ain't waiting the man's 3 months.
How you gonna do that?
It's all laid out, taken care of.
Attention, attention, Murphy, B120951, Fort to Janowski, Brzezinski, Wiley, McCann, you men have business.
They got me ticketed to counseling. You do whatever you want, but, I forget. Can I get you some coffee?
No. I didn't request being here.
You were remanded, Mr. Murphy.
Oh, I don't know why. I don't need counseling.
Explosive violence, volatile personality, EEG normal, MMPI indicates potential for explosive rage. Mm-hmm. Well, look, we're gonna do this. Anyway, so if you want to answer my question, that's fine. If not, that's cool. Refuses all visits, no family contact, no TV, no job, no commissary credit. What's going on here? Why?
I don't need any of that.
Well, let me ask you this. All you seem to do around here is run. Why is that? Does it make you feel good?
Yeah.
And when you run, do you pretend you're outside the walls? Where does it take you? In wheat fields, beach?
What do you mean?
Do you pretend you're someplace else? With some guys, it's their choppers. Other guys, their family.
Oh, I see. I'm here. I'm nowhere else. I'm here. I belong here, in this place. I am convicted. Murder one. I did it. Now, I am doing my own time. I mess with no one. No one messes with me. I did what I did. It's over. That's it.
You don't want to talk about it?
No, I do not.
Okay. Well, maybe you can do me a favor. The Department of Corrections is sending a couple of Sacramento State distance runners through here. They need somebody to show them around, maybe run with them. Do you mind?
I work up to a fast mile at 10 o'clock and 3:30. They show up, terrific. They can run.
Good.
Sure.
For a weekend of love.
Yeah, can you do it?
Yeah, man. Trick out your jacket, sneak your wife on in here, it's done. Just shuffle you around in the old roster. Ready?
Yeah, that's it.
Conjugal visit? No problem, baby. No big thing. You got it.
Hey, what's it cost?
I don't know. Hey, man, what you mean you don't know? Hey, what is this? I mean, Jimmy Jack said that... Hey, dig it, man. I mean, this is strictly business. Now, if we could do business, hey, that's fine. But if we can't do business, hey, that's fine, too. But I don't want no kind of open-ended jailhouse obligation run down on me, Jack. Hey, you know something? You sound like one of them sharp kind of dudes. No, but I ain't stupid. Hey, what do you think I'm running here? You think I'm running some kind of a mafia? Huh? Hey, do I look like I'm with the FBI, baby? Hey, man, what's wrong with you? I mean, if we can't help each other do easy time, I mean, who's gonna do it? Right? The man? Besides, what are you gonna do for a captain of industry like me, huh, baby?
Sugar for your pruno steel, man. Didn't Jimmy Jack tell you? Hey, that's what we talking.
Listen, man, if it's gonna make you feel better, do something for me, because I'm gonna do this little thing for you. That's cool. All right, sometime you can slip me an ice cream bar, huh? Meantime. There'll be some papers in your house after 10:30 lunch. You sign them and you get them back to Jimmy Jack this afternoon. You want to see your old lady.
My man, what's up? You got my Bonnaroos?
Right here, man.
All right. Yeah.
Hey, Murph! Wait up!
Yeah, like I was saying, you need to lengthen your stride a little bit.
Man, you could cut somebody with these.
I gotta sharpen up, man. Gotta get me some smell well out of the canteen. Gonna bathe it. But look tight, right, and relax.
So busy jiving with Whitey, man. You didn't even know your own brothers.
Yeah, and that's for real. Hey, what the hell is it to you, man?
Ah! Hey, man.
You got questions about me? Here I am.
But what you gonna do, huh? You gonna jump in my chest?
What are you, Frankenstein's mama? The blob? The fly?
Yeah, you must be something, man. Yeah, plus you've been peddling your grocery store action to Jimmy Jack and Dr. D.
Cutting those Nazis in on the political economy of Africanism. What's wrong with you, man?
Hey, man, they got what I need.
All you need is brothers, and the only brothers you need in this place are black.
That's right. And maybe whatever they gave you, we'll take it away.
Get off my case!
Hey, Lickety Split, where you going, huh? Huh? Yeah, what you been telling this colored boy that got his head so turned around?
Huh?
Nothing. Oh, nothing. Fast answer. You fast, huh, Lickety Split? You fast enough? I'm gonna tell you something, man. You have been knocking at my window. Now you are beating at my door. Come on, y'all.
You all right?
Yeah.
You were a slave.
Hey, man, I ain't no more of a slave than you or anybody else. I hustle up a scam to see my old lady and my kid, man. I ain't waiting no damn 3 months. I've gone this far, I go all the way.
You are on Dr. D's juice, is what you are.
So? Ain't nothing in this world for free, man. Hey, I will pay what I owe.
You don't know what you owe.
Hey, man, if I have to, I kick back, get a shank, and I off that dog, if that's what I gotta do.
Yeah, and pull a life jolt? After that nickel you bought in Quentin, man, that's really thinking ahead.
Yeah, and what are you into?
Man, I am into nothing. That's how I do my time.
Yeah, right. Well, I need things, mister. You see, that's our difference, Mr. Murphy. You don't need nobody. You run until you can't walk. Then you zone out like a glue sniffer till you can't talk. And then maybe you tired enough to get some sleep. Until the next day when you gotta go through the whole thing again. Now, Mr. Murphy, you don't need nobody. Yeah, no way, no how. See, you don't have to do no kind of desperate stuff. You got to be the luckiest man alive.
Boys, they're using R&R, receiving and release for a locker room.
You gonna run on that?
That's all we've got.
Well, where is he?
There he is.
Murphy! Mr. Murphy!
Ray Murphy, this is Jerry Bloyd from Sacramento State. And these men
Jose
are...
Jose Brigada, Dave Myers, and Babcock. Let's go, huh? I only got 20 minutes. Go where, man? The garbage cans. 4 times around the garbage cans is a mile.
Around the garbage cans. Right.
Yeah.
Hey, baby, you cool. Yeah, you are right. You are outrageous, righteous, and relaxed. Boom. Right. Hey. Thank you.
Gun is set. Go!
Tell my guys, let your boy have his race until the last quarter, then smoke him. Now, 356.8 is the best time Frank Davies turned all year. Frank Davies is the second fastest mile in the United States. Your boy's only 4 seconds slow, and he's running over gopher holes around some garbage cans.
You put him on a decent track.
Get him some decent gear. He's in basketball shoes. What do you train?
I don't. I just run.
You run every day?
Yeah, every day. Except when it rains. Then they don't let me out.
Well, what's your distance in a week?
I don't know. You know, 80, 90 miles, I guess.
You do wind sprints?
Yeah, I feel like.
What do you run, intervals, pyramids, you know, any training routine?
No. What are those?
How long does it take you to cool down?
You know, a couple of minutes, I guess. I don't know.
I used to run distance. Some days I'd work out and everything was just right. Head was in the right place. Everything was cooked. Wouldn't feel the pain. Wouldn't even feel the ground. Almost like I was,
floating.
That's right, floating. You get that feeling?
Yeah. Yeah, usually I do.
Well, that's where everybody is when they do small things like break records. Of course, your knees are hurting. You have that hamstring problem. Yeah. You know, real ache pain.
Yeah, how you know that?
Okay, I'm a believer. Let's get down to business. We're gonna have Mr. Murphy to start training.
What?
What's your shoe size?
Let's go on back to my office.
Training?
Real.
For what?
Didn't you tell him?
We kind of wanted to ease into it.
Training for what?
The OAU Nationals. The qualifications start in 4 weeks.
The OAU. We want to furlough you to qualify you to race.
Me? Not me. Forget it.
Why not you? You got no idea how important an opportunity.
Yeah, the OAU, it's the Olympic trials.
I can't do that.
What?
I said forget it, man. No way, not me. I won't do that.
Murphy.
What was that? Why can't he do it? What is this?
What he's saying is he can't do it and then come back in here.
Why? Why not?
Because he's a lifer, Jerry. He tries to pretend it doesn't exist out there.
Oh, Steve! Baby! Oh, baby!
Don't turn around. Your wife couldn't make it. This chick coming in place. Make like she's your woman. It is a very important type thing that you do not screw up.
It's so good to see you. Did you worry because I was late? I couldn't help it. Oh, baby.
Come on, Sugar, make the man believe it.
Where's my wife and my baby girl?
The guard's eyeballing us. Look, your old lady be here for trick time next time, okay? What's the big deal? Come on.
Visitors, clear the area.
What part of this game are you? Huh?
Waylee.
That's my wife's name.
Are you crazy?
Visit to report to the trailer.
Come on, we gotta get up to the trailer.
What you running down on me?
Don't you know what's going down? Can we just stay cool? Look, the money has already gone down. You just take what I give you back inside and it'll be cool. That's all. You don't want love, it's cool. I'll just say I'm sick. We don't have to do the 48 hours.
So what's to it?
What it is, man. Two balloons. Everybody's leaving.
Couple of balloons. I'm supposed to be Dr. D's damn junk mule? I'm gonna let Dr. D rob me of seeing my old lady and my new kid? The mule and his smack?
Please, Mr.
Ain't gonna happen, sweet meat! Fix it up, right? Only it weren't Waylee who showed. Some hooker with a couple of balloons of smack. I guess they figured one broad is supposed to be the same as the next. Shh. I boogied. They busted her.
Get off the main line.
Man, I don't know.
Get off the main line. Get in isolation. Get a transfer out. You gotta get out. You gotta get safe. Dr. D and them, they are an army.
I can't do isolation time.
Yes, you can. You can. You are strong enough. Hey, Mr. Stiles, are you going to tell me they invented the hard time you can't handle? Huh? Or is it just me you can't live without, huh?
Right. Right. Because without me coaching you, without Captain Midnight filling your hoochie soul with funky inspiration, ain't no way you gonna be champion.
Yeah, I mean, who am I gonna have to run with and drive me nuts, huh? Yelling kick, kick, kick.
That's right, that's right.
You know, because I'm gonna win a gold medal in the Olympics. It is all set. It is laid on.
Hey, 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 instead of your hand over your heart, are you giving them the black power sign? You can give the whole world the jailhouse salute.
Yeah.
dreams, expectations. It never happened, man. They're the worst, the worst. Nothing happens.
Oh, man. Come on, come on. Yeah. Hey. 4 o'clock unlock's coming up. You go through mess hall number one to the guard station, okay? And you boogie, I'ma be right behind you. What are you doing? Hey!
Screwed up, man.
Styles! Me to run, I will run. But you gotta give me what I want.
What's that, a license to kill somebody?
Oh, no, I do not want to kill anybody.
What then?
Metal Industries, 30 minutes inside the Metal Industries, alone.
I did you the favor when I ran. You owe me. I want to do something for Stiles.
When?
Now. Do we have a deal? Or do we not have a deal?
I got Janowski's call.
Okay, let's clear the area.
What the hell is this?
Hey, I don't want to hear. Let's go.
Move it out of there.
I gotta get my stuff. Hey, can't you hear? I said, let's go.
Yeah, but we got...
Hey, save it. Let's get out of here. Come on, let's move it out. These are weird.
Yeah, there'll be a pair of spikes when you get a tractor runner.
Can't get a kick without spikes.
Now, your shoulders are too tense and you're stiff and small in your back. I'll give you a warm-up for that. Keep your jaw loose and your shoulders loose and make you hang loose.
Okay.
Okay, we'll start off with two 220s, two 440s, and then a couple of slow 880s, and a fast 220 to finish. First thing we want to develop is your knowledge of pace.
You gonna teach me how to run right, Professor?
It's no right. It's what's right for you. What's natural, you know, your own style. We're just going to take you into a faster, stronger, more powerful place.
All right. Ready for the 440? Yeah.
Oh, hey, Janowski asked me to give you something. told me to tell you to read the back. What's it say?
To the Jericho Mile. What's that mean?
Maybe it's got to do with the walls come tumbling down. You ready?
Here.
What the hell do you mean I can't furlough him until he qualifies? I can't qualify him unless I can furlough him. He's got to run a qualifying time in an OAU-sanctioned race. Well, that's real fine. While you're protecting your rear, I've got a unique opportunity here I'm supposed to blow? I don't think so. We got a new problem.
I heard.
Karen, get Sam in here.
How can we get an OAU-sanctioned race here so we can get an official time for Murphy so he can run in the Olympic trials?
Sam, get the lawyer on the phone and go through the California Criminal Code to see what authority I have to run a race here.
Okay, I'll try.
No, the track doesn't need much work. We can have that managed by the 17th.
That track's got to be perfectly graded. There's all kinds of specs. It's not easy.
Well, don't you worry about a thing. The track's going to be beautiful. Beautiful.
All right.
Doc?
What?
Dinner?
No. Okay, I'll see you later. Now, what I want to know is how we're going to turn that cow pasture into an OAU track complete to specs by the 17th.
Well, you get the specifications, Doc. I'll get the labor.
Attention on the yard, attention on the yard. Johnson, Salenko, Sweet, you have visitors. Krasinski, report to R&R. Attention on the yard. Warren Gulliver will address you.
You met in A custody and medium B custody. You saw the last race that inmate Larry R. Murphy ran here. You know how fast he is. Some people from the outside believe that he may be among the 5 or 6 fastest mile runners in the country. Now we're going to stage another race. An OAU sanctioned race right here inside Folsom. If we can get an officially clocked qualifying time for Murphy that's fast enough, it'll make him eligible to try out for the U.S. Olympic team.
He ain't running in nothing.
So, we're going to construct our own quarter-mile track and hold our own race right here, inside, on the yard.
I tell you what, the only thing that guy is going to run in is the
men who have jobs in the upper yard industries, furniture fabrication, and a power plant, who want to work constructing this track, you'll be given time off. I'd like you to get behind the building of this track so that we can run this race here. Thank you.
Okay, why not?
Ain't our problem, you know what I mean? The brotherhood is interested in getting the mind and the body together, that's it.
It ain't gonna happen.
No way.
No way.
Come
here, let's talk for a minute.
Come on, you guys. All right.
Let's go.
Check it out.
Let's go.
What is this?
What it is a boycott. This is a picket line. You don't want anybody out there working on that track.
What are you talking about?
Rain Murphy ain't running nowhere, no way, no how. Because the dude busted our stash, and that breaks the code.
Who are you, man? All
right, got
you.
Wait.
Okay, man, we're going to respect your picket, your boycott. Only because you say it's political. All right, that's it.
Come on, let's go.
Do it, man.
Hey, man, get off the track! We're gonna remember you. Hey. All right, go to work, sucker.
Man, white man's game, white man's running, white man's problem. You know what I mean?
Y'all sure missing those styles out there, running around the track with that white boy, bouncing around that track. Like he had air. You know what I mean? Like he flew, kind of.
I think he was in love with it.
Yeah, punk. Let me love with
you. Back off, man. Hold it.
You need this sort of thing, brother.
Anyway, man, come on. Let's just go drive some iron and try to get our minds in tune with our bodies, all right?
What you gonna do about Styles, man, huh? What you gonna do about him?
We're gonna do something about Styles. Someday soon.
He telling you right, big brother.
Don't you ever get tired? It's almost supper time.
You're driving.
Get tired driving.
2 more miles, then you can have your supper.
How's my boy doing?
He's doing fine. He's training his heart out for this thing.
Terrific.
You can't believe how fast he is. And I don't think this track's gonna be done on time, Earl. You are jiving me.
Yeah, well, some yahoo's called a strike there with my labor force.
Well, do something about it.
There's nothing to do. It's principle. No convicts going to step across a picket line, period.
I could pack it in.
Hey,
you only
no.
4 days.
This thing happening could mean more to convicts all over this country than 15 years of rehab programs put together.
You keep saying that, but so what? There's not gonna be any race.
Murphy's a model for connecting to the outside. Backing him means a lot.
Because not connecting means staying into the games on that yard. Then they hit the streets, they cop out into their comic book fantasies, screw up an armed robbery, kill a few people, and then they're right back in here. That's why one Murphy, who can plug into street values instead of jailhouse values, and score is worth so much. Because he breaks down the games they play. And that's why Murphy's got to run. And that's why I don't give a damn. We don't give up until we're beat, and that's not till 4 days from now, by God. You and I ain't never gonna get our ideology.
Hey, man. Don't jive me, all right? Don't jump up in my face. Now, just tell me, did you take the wind out of that black brother?
Yeah, that's right. I did it. Now, I'm gonna lay it out for you. You don't want to hear it, that's just fine. You want a race war? You want to stomp and shank each other all over that yard out there? Close down his whole damn joint? Yeah, man, yeah. Anytime you want, anytime. And do you want to hear it or not?
All right, man, let's hear it.
All right.
See, old brother Styles, now see, he's got this conjugal visit time coming up, you understand? He comes up with some ABC scheme he lays on me to switch in my mule instead of his wife. Can you dig it? But a dude loses his cool, see? My best mule gets busted, man. But now there's skin searching every chick that comes through those gates, man, for conjugal awful visitation. Now, what I'm telling you is punching this dude's ticket was righteous.
Let me take that.
No. Just back off. Just back off. Recruiting that brother was an invasion of my space.
See, I didn't recruit him, General. Somebody else tripped on over and snaked him on in and sent him on up to see me. Somebody else recruited him, Brother Cotton.
Oh, yeah? Who was that?
Brother Cotton, if I give you this man, I'm giving up one of my own people. Make it up.
That's extra compensation. Zeroes us out.
All right, man, who?
Look at his split.
Jack, man ain't gonna let you leave just yet.
Stay down, fool. Don't be no crazy than what you are. Stay down! Stay down, fool! Where you going, boy?
I'm gonna nail you.
Oh, yeah?
You badmouth my friend.
The man was my brother.
Yeah, all right, man. Then where you gonna go after you get me?
Gotta finish my workout.
Come on, man, I need your hand. Talk to you for a minute, man. Look here, man, I'm gonna take on that picket line. Because I've been jiving, I've been hyped, you know what I mean? But I'm gonna need your help to pull it off.
Why should we back your action?
Hey, man, what did that chump Dr. D tell you that picket line was?
He told us it was political.
Yeah.
Let me talk to my canales.
I'm gonna get your queen. I'm gonna romp her and stomp her and jump on her in ways that'll traumatize her for the rest of her life.
Hey, look at this.
What do we got here?
All right. Brother Cotton? What's happening, huh?
Ain't nothing happening, sucker, except you.
What's that?
You standing in our way.
Well, this is a picket line, man. This is the strike.
Hey, man, I don't want to hear that madness. You ain't nothing but a jive con artist, you know that? And this ain't no picket line. This ain't no strike. What this is here is a labor brigade, dig it?
This is a picket line. This is political, man.
This is not a political situation. This is a pocket situation. Your pocket. That's what this is.
All right, man. Wait. If we can't work out on the yard, we're gonna work out on your head.
Hey. What is this, huh?
What it is the United Front Labor Brigade and Militia. Can you dig it?
So get out of the way, Lane.
Listen to me, nigga.
Hey, I'm one of them nigger type, dude. Oh. I'm a nigger person.
Hey, you Mexican cracker jack man. Shut up, rat face sucker. Now I'm Mexican, too. So what you gonna do, huh? You gonna jump in the face of my Mexican blood, huh?
Your window this morning, you'll see something you won't believe.
I'd believe anything this morning. I got 6 men in the hospital.
Just look out your window.
Man, you can have my chicken.
Fruit's good for you, man. Eat plenty of fruit.
You heard the man.
Brother, good luck.
Vitamin D, baby.
Got more?
No, 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 thanks.
How does that track feel?
It's good. No, it's real good.
Larry, tell me, what was killing your father all about? Why'd you take his life?
Damn, what is this? What the hell is this? I got a race to run out there in 2 days.
Yeah, well, that's Beloit's problem. You as a sociological phenomenon or whatever is Gulliver's problem. You as you is what I'm interested in, and I think that we have talked enough that we can get into this area.
Yeah, well, I don't. All right, Larry. It's all right. Forget it. We don't have to talk about it.
You know, I loved the man. I mean, I loved him. Maybe I didn't. Maybe I just tell myself a Jack story, you know?
Maybe both feelings are true.
He was drunk, okay? And he was bashing my stepsister. And she's 14 years old. And he is bashing her all the time. And I walk in on him. And there he is. And I know, man, this stops. I mean, he was an animal. So I know this is gonna end. And if it puts me in here for the rest of my life, then that's okay, because somebody has gotta stop this, you see? Somebody has gotta stop this bad seed. It has gotta stop. They told me that I shot him over and over again. And if you put me in here, then that's okay. I mean, I did what I had to do. And once he took me to Ocean Park when I was six. We had this this big yellow car, and there's Guy Lombardo music playing on the radio. And my mom had this dress, you know, with big flowers. And he won me one of those goldfish in the carny booth knocking over milk bottles. And he picked me up, and he took me over to the shooting gallery so I could shoot, and man, the sun was on the water, on the pier right underneath us, you know. And he held me on his shoulders all day. And he held me up there all day.
As an adult, out on the street, why didn't you try to get some help for your old man?
Oh, man, it's what it was, you know. And he, my old man, was replating bumpers for cars. I'm working in a scrapyard in San Pedro. We were not exactly plugged into shrinks with the big fancy couches, you know what I mean? I mean, what went down is what went down. And this is where I belong.
You still believe that?
I don't know. Everything's just gotten a little mixed up.
You gonna make it?
I think so. Yeah. I am going to make it, yeah.
Thank you.
day after tomorrow, you stay off the lead runner's right shoulder, which will be Frank Davies. Now, right behind him, you get boxed in the way Ryan did in the 72 Olympics. Now, Davies has got the edge on race experience. He's strong, and he's got a big kick for the finish. Basically, a sprinter doing a mile.
Okay, so what do I do?
You fall in behind, run his race, press him from the back, demoralize him with your presence, make him worry. Then pick your moment, hit your kick. That's one strategy.
What's another?
Well, you're as strong as he is, maybe stronger. If you had the experience, I'd say you take the lead so you can set the pace. And be sure to tire him out, wear him out chasing you, wipe out all his reserves for the last quarter sprint.
What'll he expect me to do?
Falling behind.
Go for it. I'm gonna grab the lead and I'm gonna hang on to it.
But in that fourth quarter, he'll come on like gangbusters.
That's okay, that's okay. Listen, what are you getting out of all this?
What do you mean?
What are you getting out of this?
You see, when I was in competition, I knew how to run fast. But I couldn't be fast. Not that fast. Not like you. So I see you, and let me tell you, I've been waiting my whole career for someone like you to come along. Let's run some easy 440s.
Yes, Murphy.
What about Davies?
Davies, yes.
Holmes?
Holmes, yes.
No, no, that's Beetson.
Beetson is right there.
Say, man, where you walking? That's the track.
Fourth quarter, he's got that big kick now. He'll be out to get you.
Yeah.
hell are you talking about?
It's a complete surprise to me, too.
What does it mean?
I told you, I don't know. It's probably a formality.
The OEU got a beef about the track or the way we ran the time? Have them tell us right now.
I don't think that's a problem.
It better not be a problem. The OAU meets in 4 days.
Look, the time and the track is valid. I checked, all right?
Okay. Boy, he looked good out there.
He should have. He's run the fifth fastest mile in the U.S. this year. Those OAU guys are publicity hounds. They probably want more pictures taken. Actually, I'm more concerned how Rain handles Los Angeles in 4 days.
We can start. Is everybody comfortable? Mr. Murphy?
Yeah, I'm fine. Thank you. Sorry.
Anybody like some water? Well, Mr. Gulliver, let's get into the issues at hand.
Wait a minute. I don't understand. Why is Mr. Murphy's running an issue? I mean, once a runner establishes his time...
I know, but unfortunately, this organization is not government-funded. We get funds from private individuals and corporations. And to be candid, it is of importance to us to keep our image clean.
Does the board intend to investigate judicial or penological matters?
No. We have no credentials in that area. But to what extent the participation
what
of Murphy
this?
In OAU competition is going to affect our organization, it is a realistic consideration, that's all. And I want to apologize, Mr. Murphy, to impose this bureaucratic nuisance on such a fine athlete and to drag you in to listen to this. Mr. Gulliver, how does your institution function in regards to prisoners like Murphy?
We call them inmates.
Inmates.
Our job is to keep the men incarcerated in state custody while they serve their sentences and to encourage moves towards coping with the real world as it exists outside of our walls. So if they re-enter society...
Well, for shorthand, we can use that good old term, rehabilitate.
That's no longer current.
Mr. Murphy, tell me, do you feel that you have been rehabilitated?
I'm not really sure in my case.
Do you feel differently about what you did? Are you reformed? I mean, that kind of stuff. I mean, Mr. Murphy, are you sorry?
Yeah, I'm sorry. For everything.
Okay. Well, would you do it again?
Now, that could be a difficult question.
I don't know.
You don't know? Who did you murder?
Look, you can't ask that question of this man in this room when he's tense. My father.
Now, you know what he's done. You have his file there. This man is talking about an extraordinary circumstance. I think we can all see that. Now, you don't have to be a judge or a psychologist.
If you were in the same circumstances, in the same place, would you commit the crime again? I mean, I think it's worth talking about here, isn't it?
Come on, please. I don't really know. You're harping on this man. This is about athletics. Now, this guy's the greatest natural runner I've ever seen. Now, why don't
you... Look, there were diminished mental faculties, in my opinion, due to a unique situation that I have gone over in great detail in the background material, and it's in the folder.
Would you do it again, Mr. Murphy? I mean, I think people would like to know that.
You were running a game down on us. Before breakfast, before you finished breakfast, you decided I am not running in your race.
Would you do it again?
Man, I hate what happened. But I will not repudiate what happened. And I won't repudiate myself because all I've got is my name and my face. In the same place, in the same time, in the same conditions, I would blow him away all over again. You got that? Man, you are a snake. You wouldn't last 10 minutes in the yard. Not 10 minutes.
signed off for now with the Signature Insurance Company. We just brought you the letter.
Skin, man.
Is Mr. Wall Entertainment Twister Blast brought to you by Twister Wine? Hey, mister, go out and buy a bottle of Twister Wine.
Hey! What do you want?
Hey, sucker. You know you're not allowed in here. Get on, man. Get to stepping.
Los Angeles, Frank Davies ran the mile in 350.6, just 1.2 seconds off John Walker's world record. That makes Frank Davies a leading candidate for the U.S. Olympic team, and a good prospect for a gold medal in 1,500 meters at Moscow. In other men's events, Frank Lohman of San Diego took the 60-yard high hurdles, and John Strapata of Bakersfield won the high jump.
Check this out, man.